Hey guys, it's Becky. I am back with another process video. Today I'm going to be using a paper collection I picked up at Tuesday morning and also this sketch right here from Creative Scrappers. It is still my goal to use all those sketches. This is the paper collection, It's Beautiful Life by Laura Passage for Echo Park. Now I preemptively went in and fussy cut some flowers and some doilies with butterflies on them that I thought I might want to use, which I did use. And right here I'm trimming down this ampersand paper. This is going to serve as my background and this diagonal stripe is going to serve as my border. I've only been scrapbooking a few years, and from the very get-go the diagonal stripes have gotten me, and still they do. I still love them. I don't really think that's a phase. I think that's just going to be a thing, right? So here I'm going to go ahead and take the pieces that I cut out and kind of try and arrange them around the page. Now they are going to move a little bit, of course. As you saw right there, I had that sketch on its side up against the page. That's how I'm going to use it. I'm not really going to use it in the way it was designed. I'm just turning it on its side a little bit. So that diagonal piece is going to be at the bottom left corner instead of being at the top. I haven't done the diagonal piece yet, but I will. Right here, I'm just kind of placing it around. These right here are some little, well, what I just did over at the right, and actually these two are some sticker bits. And I did want to use those circles, and by the time I glued everything down, I forgot about the circles. And so I didn't put them on. They were just sitting on my desk, like stuck to my lamps. It's insane how we do that, right? We'll pull out a piece and we're like, I'm going to use this piece, and we put it to the side for when it's time to glue them down, and then we forget to do it. I do that all the time. It's crazy. Here's another sticker. The thing with these paper packs is that you get all those papers and then you get this one sheet of stickers. You don't have any embellishments. So basically, you have to find things in your stash that will coordinate with them, or you can fussy cut the papers, which is what I did in this instance. I also pulled out that camera sticker and put it up on some foam tape. Totally, my intention was to use it. I did not use it. So I'm going to have to keep this collection out and do another layout with those bits that I had already pulled off, because that was my intention. So I'm going to go ahead and stick down my ampersand paper to the diagonal stripe paper, two of my favorite things, right? Right here. Of course, yeah, I cut that out. I ran out of tape because I video everything, so obviously I'm going to run out of tape in some of the videos, right? So I'm going to go ahead and put these back down where they were. I am going to pull out some ink. It is from Lawn Fawn, and it is called Dough. And I'm going to ink the edges of all the bits I'm going to use. I don't think I show you the ink. You will see me ink in the little bits. Right there on that one doily I had cut, I put the sticker on it from the sticker sheet. When I end up placing that, you don't even see that flower sticker I put on there. So that's kind of funny. That right there is a little camera sticker, and I had pulled it out and I even put it up on some foam tape, totally intentionally trying to use it. That was my intent, was to use that camera. I forgot about that piece too. It is so weird how we do that. So right here I'm looking back at the sketch and I'm like, well, I need to have a couple strips over to the right hand side. So I'm going to cut out a strip of these butterflies and it's going to go right there. Then I'm going to pull out another paper and I'm going to cut a strip of it, and it is going to be green with some hearts on it. Right here I'm backing the photo on that music paper. The photo was already previously matted on white, and so I matted it again on the music paper. Go ahead and trim that up because it's pretty raggedy the way I cut it. I cut that by hand, not well at all. I'm gonna go ahead and stick that down right there. So this base is almost made. I just need to do a couple more things. I pushed things around, even though I was using a sketch on this one, I did push things around a lot. Right there, I wanted to move that sticker up, but it was stuck, so it was not moving up, so I just went ahead and moved the green paper down a little bit to kind of try and make it work. And I'm going to go ahead and start placing things down again. Here's where I realized, oh, I'm missing that triangle bit on the corner, so I'm going to pull out this green again. And then I'm going to decide I actually want to mat that on something. So I'm going to pull out a floral paper and mat it on there. I don't think you see that. Right here is where I went ahead and pulled out that ink from Lawn Fawn, the dough color, and I'm going to ink the edges of things. But of course, I had already put down the corner, so it made it a little bit difficult. I did rip the page pulling it up, but it ends up working out fine in the end. Okay, so you can see I'm working with this photo of my son, right? And you might be saying, Becky, why are you using all these flowers and butterflies on a photo of your son? That's just kind of weird. Well, here's the thing. I've said this in a previous video. He and Marissa moved away. They moved to Arizona. They'll be back. I mean, it's okay. They're going to come back in like June or July. But anyway, so they moved away and Marissa sent me this picture, and she is so sweet, guys. She knows that I'm going to miss my child's face, right? She sends me pictures of him all the time. At least once a week, she will snap a photo of him and send it to me and be like, we were doing this or we were doing that, or just send a picture by itself with no explanation. It doesn't matter. She sends me pictures of him, and she is so sweet. I am talking about her in this journaling. So she's BJ's girlfriend now. She's not technically my daughter-in-law because they are not married or anything as of yet. But if I did have a daughter-in-law, I hear people complain about their daughter-in-laws or their son's girlfriends. I don't have anything to complain about. She is so sweet, guys. And I am just so blessed because who snaps photos and sends them to the mom? That's just wonderful, right? I just think that's really, it's really special. So anyways, this is a photo of him, but my title is actually going to read about her, and then my journaling is going to be about Marissa, because she sent me this photo. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and start layering up here at the top. Those are just going to be a whole bunch of flowers that I fussy cut out. I am going to ink all of them with that Lawn Fawn ink. I didn't think about the inking before I put down those stickers. So those stickers are kind of flat against the page and they have zero ink around them. And you can, it's obvious to me sitting here looking at this page, but maybe it wouldn't be to someone else. I don't know. Whatever. That's the way it is. That's the way it's going to stay. So if I would have thought about it in advance, I would have probably tried to ink those stickers. All right, so that butterfly up at the top, it did go up on a little bit of foam tape, the one on the doily. And then down here at the bottom, I put another fussy cut flower and then that doily right there. And up at the top, I am going to put this doily that I put a sticker on. The sticker ends up being completely covered up. And I'm going to put a fussy cut flower over the top of it, that red one. I like this collection, but I'm not going to lie. I didn't buy it because I just loved it. I got it because it was a Tuesday morning, right? If I saw this collection on scrapbook.com, probably I wouldn't have gotten it. It's not necessarily my style, but I got it. And you know, I have that $5 rule. So like this collection, I think, how much are they? $5.99. So for every $5, I have to make at least one layout. So I have to make another layout or a card or something out of this collection before I send it on to somebody else. That's just kind of this rule I made for myself for no apparent reason. Right here are the stickers I'm going to use. They are the Lindsay font. And like I had previously told you, the title is going to be about her. I'm going to move it around a little bit just to get it adjusted just right. I do end up putting it down with some liquid adhesive, as we do with stickers. And then I'm going to write the journaling right there over to the right of the title. I actually don't have a whole lot of journaling, but just a little box. right here. I am using a Studdler pin for that, and I think the one I use is in brown. And it, like right here, I'm looking at it, and it almost reads as a light black, maybe a gray, but it is in brown. And I forgot, there was one more thing I wanted to talk about. Jeannie over at GWiz65 has started doing her 2018 project. Last year she did the 2017 with the paper pads, but this year she's doing the 2018 paper crafting project, and you can use whatever you want to do. I am actually thinking about joining her maybe in March. Right now, this is going to go up the last day of February. I don't know if I'll join in March, but maybe in April, because, you know, the surgery and stuff. I don't know how I'm going to be feeling at the time, but I am definitely going to try and join in with that. I love watching her videos. I love listening to her voice. She's just amazing. I don't know why. It's just like, you hear her voice and you're like, oh, we're friends. She just has that friend voice, right? All right, guys. I did some sequins, I did some splatters with Heidi Swap Color Shine NT, and after I did that, I didn't do anything else to this layout. I'm linking Jeannie down below if you want to check out her 2018 paper crafting project. I'm going to link it down below. I just saw the video today because I have a ton of stuff and watch later. Sorry about that. Alright guys, thank you so much for joining me. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye guys.